Welcome to the channel and No Man's Sky, Permadeath and Extreme Challenge, as it says on the screen. I'm going to start by saying that I know a lot of you guys don't like long intros. This could be a long intro, so there will be a timestamp in the video description if you want to jump forward into the actual gameplay. Now that out of the way, let's get down to what this is not going to be. This is not going to be me doing some dash to the center of the galaxy in Permadeath mode, blow by blow, just to prove that I haven't died. There are quite a few guys live streaming this, trying to do it, and I wish them luck. And there's probably one or two I can think of who are going to succeed. But this is not the purpose of this Let's Play. Purely and simply because, one, I can't live stream for technical reasons, mainly to do with the internet. And two, I don't want this to be a blow by blow series, because I'm very much aware, I mean, I do watch these live streams, that No Man's Sky is the type of games when there's long periods of, which I would say is not particularly exciting things to watch, because there's times when you're going to be farming for credits or traveling long distances or just doing very, very little. While it's interesting to play it, it's not very particularly interesting to watch. So that's what this series is not going to be. So why am I doing it if I've said that? Well, for two reasons. The first reason is pretty pragmatic. I've been playing No Man's Sky ever since it came out in August of 2016, and I've been producing content. I've done various kind of run-throughs from the beginning, and the nature of the Pathfinder update, in fact most of the updates that have dropped, is that a lot of the changes affect the whole gameplay, so you're really, to experience it, you've got to start again. But that's effectively the situation I'm in now. But in order to kind of show you guys what the new changes are, how it affects the way you approach, you've got to start again. And as you can see here, I've already got a survival mode. I only play survival mode. I've never played normal mode since the foundation release came up. I've never been in sandbox mode, and I don't want to just drop that survival mode series just at the moment, and I emphasize the word just at the moment. So to show you guys and to learn a bit more about the game, and so I know what I'm talking about, I've got no choice. I've got to do a permadeath. And that's the nature of what I've got to do. Now, the second reason is that I do like the idea of permadeath mode, and it is a personal challenge. So I will be trying to get to the center of the galaxy without dying. If I do die, I will stop and restart again, because that's my objective. So if I died and then reloaded the game and tried to carry on, I wouldn't be cheating you guys, I'd be cheating myself, because I would, eventually when I got to the center of the galaxy, I would know that I didn't do it in one life. So that's the kind of other reason to doing it. So that out of the way, I'm just going to say that in the future, permadeath will be the permanent series that will go the distance. When the next update drops, which there will be probably in 3 months' time or 4 months' time, survival mode will become the new presentation play, which will then be reset every time there's a new update. So permadeath will carry on till I die, and then I'll restart. If for some reason the permadeath coincides with an update, then the permadeath will swap. So that's my thinking for the long term. Permadeath will be my personal Let's Play, and I will use that to demonstrate gameplay and things, and I'll probably give you updates on it, and survival mode. But that's when the next update comes out. I'm thinking really ahead, because I think the way these updates are coming from Hello Games, these are always going to be quite dramatic, often game-changing. They're not going to be the small tinkering that you often get with other games. So that all done, let's get into it. So what is permadeath? Well, permadeath really and truthfully is survival mode with one game save. Now, if you're familiar with the game, you know that you save games by getting out ships and saving manually, and you only get 3 save files. Well, all permadeath does is every time you save, it writes to all 3 files. So you've only got the 1 file. When you die, that's deleted and you're back to the start position. So that's all permadeath is. It's survival mode with 1 save game. And of course, because you can't choose when to save, it means that you are moving forward very, very quickly. Every time you get out your ship and things like that, you save. So we might as well just get into it now, guys. I won't bore you with the cutscene intro.
System Scanner damaged. Repair required. Aerial propulsion jetpack. Online. Multi-tool and mining laser attachment. Operational. User initialization sequence complete.
Oh well, here we are, guys. We're on a base. Oh, this could be interesting. Just gonna get in out of the cold while I kind of talk a little bit. Because obviously this is survival mode, therefore it is going to be a bit cold. For any of you guys who skipped the intro, this is going to be a permadeath run in survival mode. Now, it's a personal challenge. It's not the real purpose of this, of my recordings. My recordings is to talk about gameplay and strategy and kind of experience the changes from the Pathfinder update. One thing I will say is that the length of the videos in this series will vary considerably. This first one will probably be about an hour long so that I can get to my ship. After that, the average length would be between 30 and 40 minutes, probably less. But if I come across something very specific that I want to do, say when we get to the home base and we're doing the exocraft missions, I may do those as short individual videos. For anyone who's not familiar with the game, permadeath is the same as survival mode. In fact, it's similar to the vanilla game. The game starts with the premise that you've crash landed on a planet and you've got a damaged multi-tool and your starship's being damaged and you've got basic survival. And the first job is to get to your ship, which means you've got to survive here. And the planet's always grim, but not completely hostile. So the kind of first thing you want to do is look at and see how far away your ship is. And sometimes it can be a bit kind of tricky to see it. So it says our ship's nearly 10 minutes away in that direction. And the first technique you've got to do is get your scanners fixed and prepared to go. And this is very much about slow movement, because your top bar is your environmental resistance, the white bar is your survival capability. Oh, we've got some here, check stock first. The white bar is your survival thing. Oh, got a base here. Now this could be interesting. Very, very interesting, guys. It's the first time I've actually ever done a survival start where I've actually started with a major base. Nanite clusters. You get nanite clusters from these now. Once you used to get tech from this for free, which means you were able to pile up very, very quickly. But now you've got to buy the tech. I'm not going to use that because I may need that later on if I run into problems. Let's go over and check out what we got over here. Now the key is you can't run. Do not use your jetpack until you've got Thamium. And I think what we can do is just throw out... Oh, the scanner's critically damaged, but we can repair that. So let's get across to here. We've met our first get guy. This is different. So let's repair the scanner. We need some iron to do the analysis visor. So let's say hello to this guy. This is a Gek, if you're new to the game, one of the three species that come with the game. And it actually says here, Fan, Unic, Surtsis. Surtsis I actually know from my Let's Play is units. So if I give him 10 units, and he gives me something in exchange. And my standing with Gek is increased, and I get some nanite clusters. Standing is very important now with the Pathfinder release, in the fact that you now have to buy techs, and to buy techs you've got, and you can only buy techs in space stations now according to your standing. So this is basically an observatory. Lifeform works and is installed. The absence of it struck gold, the beacon receives a sequence response. This is just a sequence, so it should be 2-1-2-1-2-1. You are standing with the geckos increased, so we've kind of increased our standing again. Yep, and you can see there we've got a ruin. Well, that's a maybe for a long time in the future. It's not exactly high on my list of priorities at the moment. Actually, I just had a thought, actually. Let's go here and wrap this round here. So you got the plutonium. We're going to need to mine some iron. Find some iron. Cold planets can be often very, very short of iron. So the key resources you need to find is carbon and iron. Let's just get round here. This big base, a very, very big base. And the save point is round there. Oh, we've got a free landing post. Now that is going to be very, very interesting, guys. Especially if we don't have any art thing. That changes the gameplay, because if we can get the ship repaired, there's Heridium over there. We might be able to call the ship. We may not have to do the walk. And I'm very much aware that we don't seem to have much in the way of resources here, guys. This is going to be, it's not an easy start. What I am going to do is drop a save. Now, I know this is permadeath and the save isn't particularly important. The game still crashes. Like it or not, you've still got a save. Game got a power canister, that's good. I think we're going to need to get round here. I think if we go for that one, there looks like there's some caves or something up there. We need to find iron. There's a little bit of iron there. Nowhere near enough for what we want. Yeah, this is quite a big base actually, guys. So let's just get up into here. And we'll just let the... Now, you do recover your environment very, very quickly when you are inside of a building. Inside of your ship, it's a lot slower. There's like caves up there. What we're going to do is go for a cave, because we do need to collect a lot of iron to repair our ship and keep away from the whip plant. So if I get up to the cave, it means I can collect iron without having to move that much. There's another little whip plant there. I'll just kill it so I don't walk into it by accident. Don't have a lot of carbon at the moment, so let's see if we can mine some more carbon out before I get into the cave. Yes, I know. It can be quite irritating from that. Get close enough to shoot, and that's it. There's some plutonium up there. That's going to be useful. So let's grab as much carbon as possible. I think that would be enough. And the old sentinels are turning up here. And what we'll do is we'll get up into this cave. Now, survival mode. I will refer it more to survival mode than permadeath, because to me it is survival mode. And the permadeath is just kind of a little bit of an extra comment. So once you get into a cave, it means we can now gather some of this resources quite nicely. It's good. The key factor is just to mine out the iron. Keep an eye out for the sentinels, because I'm a little bit far away from the base and I don't want the sentinels coming in and attacking me. So we'll just keep kind of pulsing the beam like that, and we should be able to get the analysis visor repaired. Get that done. How much have we got in the way? We've got one carite sheet. We're going to need seven for there, four for there, 32 zinc, 11. So we need about 550 iron. We've got 16 at the moment. Deuterium. We can't mine that because that's an exocraft mining laser. That's one of the new changes that came in with the Pathfinder. That's something else to consider. You can see the environment now is built back up. We can put that. We're going to keep the power. Oh, didn't mean to do that. That was a little bit of, it's not a fatal mistake, but not something that I intended to do. What we're going to do is just stand here and mine iron. Like I said, this is one of the elements of the game which has got to be done, but it's not particularly exciting. So if I jump, the video jumps here, all it is because I'm stood here mining. There's some antrium there. Yes, I know, Mr. Sentinel, go away please. Sometimes if you move away or walk about, they push off, and because I don't want to waste that piece of iron there. Yeah, if you keep moving with sentinels, they will often do, and if you don't look at them, if you look down, they will often lose interest. If you kind of look them in the eye, they will get a bit stroppy and they'll attack you. And the last thing I want at the moment is to attack. What I can do is send this Geknip and that to the ship, but that leaves plenty of space there. How much iron have I got? 143, so I got enough for 2 Karite sheets. And of course they now stack to a level of 5, which is very, very useful. I think that sentinel's still lurking in the background there, so I've got to keep an eye out on him. I don't want him to... we'll mine this one, and then we'll move somewhere else. We'll kind of walk away, maybe to go down here a little bit. And if you mine somewhere and then move away, they tend not to pay that much attention to you. It's when you stand in one position all the time, try mining the same area, that they can get a bit stroppy. Kind of come down here and grab a bit more iron. Just keep pulsing the laser. And what I want to do is check to see if there's another exit here. Yes, there is. No, there's not. No, bugger. It could be another exit, but the key factor is do not get lost in caves, because walking around, well, as you can see there, will consume your life support. I've got a power cell, which was a very useful find, but we really need to find Thamium. And of course we've now... Yes, I know. Just pull back a little bit. And we'll collect a bit more iron. This is quite a relaxing start, actually. My first survival run, which is the one that's fairly mature now, had a very, very frantic start. Go away, Mr. Sentinel. Because I certainly don't want to be fighting you. Yeah, I had a very, very frantic start, and it actually... I had to run for the ship in the very last moments just to survive. I think we're going to have to go and get some carbon, so we can't hang around here a bit any longer. Let's connect that one there, because we've invested the energy in doing that. And we'll just... Yes, I know. Extreme night temperature detected. And we've got plenty for there, and there was some plutonium up over here. There's a whip plant there. We'll certainly kill that on sight. These plants can really knock you out. There's nothing more irritating than being hanging on to the last moment only to be zapped by one of those and it killing you. I mean, that can really, really annoy you. I was about to press the space bar to use my jetpack. There's a bit of plutonium there. Let's throw out a scan this way, see if there's anything up here of any interest. Ooh, not much at all around here, actually, guys. I'm just gonna... Yes. So, even though I've got the potential to call the ship, as you can see, round here there's not much in the way of resources, and that's going to be an issue. Because we've got to find zinc, we've got to find iridium. So we're just going to there. The thermal protection's dropping. I don't want to be getting too cocky. We'll get back into our base. Not running, because haven't got any thamium yet. Just going to dash in here. And if you see here, we don't have ability. Until we get platinum, we can't make shielding shards. And of course, I don't want to make shielding shards in my ship, purely and simply because we don't have the resources to do it. So we got 200, so I think what we can do is make 4 more. you should be able to repair the thrusters. So we've now got the launch thrusters repaired. Now we've got to work on the pulse engine. And I've got 20 iron left. All that iron has already been consumed. We got a little bit of plutonium. So we're back up to areas there. Really, really need to try and find some platinum. So let's see if we can get out this way. And if we do this, it will get us a thamium over there. We're going to go. This resource deposit found. Be very, very suspicious of that area. Don't follow it blindly, because it's a bit kind of wacky in the sense of where it thinks the ideal resource is. Come on. Oh, come on. I don't have time for this, guys. Get out this. Sometimes you get a resource close to a tree or something and it won't actually pick it up, and sometimes you will actually find it embedded in rocks as well, which can be really annoying. So we've got some thamium now, which is good for the life support. I've got a feeling we've got iridium a lot closer than that. I'm sure I saw some iridium out that way. That's still recharging. Let's get back to the base. It says iridium that way. I don't know how far it says it is. Yeah, 5 minutes. It's not too bad, 5 minutes. But we still haven't found any platinum. We still haven't found any zinc. You do need to accept that some of these starts can be impossible. You need to remember that these starts are procedurally generated. They're totally random. Therefore, it's possible that you will have something that you cannot actually survive or build up from this point. So there's a whippy plant in there. We're certainly going to whack him. Now let's see if we can get this way. See if we can find a cave or something so we can extend our range. I'm sure I saw some some iridium out this way. Yes. Let's see if we can make our way towards the iridium. But what we're looking for is caves. There's going to be an element of risk involved in this, because we do not have the resources to do it. There's some thamium over there. That will be useful. But sometimes with this mode, you've just got to go for it, guys, a little bit. And let's see if we can find shelter. This way, we don't have a grenade launcher. There's a platinum there. That could be a lifesaver. Not enough of a lifesaver, unfortunately. There's a platinum over there. Let's make a run for it. Oh, yep. Sorry, creatures. Sorry, we're going to have to run for this, guys. Because we're going to need to try and make a shielding shard. Yes, I know. Whoops, that's Starship. Don't fall for that, guys. And we don't have enough iron. We could be in trouble here, guys. Because we need to get to that. Yes, come on, come on, come on. We can do this. It's called living on the edge. No, we still need 5 iron. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. We're in trouble, guys. We're in trouble. There's some iron over there. Actually, let's head straight for the iridium. Now, there is a trick that I can do. Yes, I know. If we hack into here. Wow. We'll gather a bit more carbon. How are we for carbon? That was a little bit too close for comfort. We got a power cell. I think we've got to use the power cell to do that. And I think we're going to recharge our mining beam that got very, very low. And while we're stood here, we'll mine some more carbon while our environmental protection is building back up again. And so that we got plenty. Okay. This is where I've got to be very, very careful. We need to mine this iridium, but at the moment it's our shelter. Get in a bit further. We need to stock up on a little bit of iron before we actually do this. Ooh. We got 73 iridium. We got enough for one thermal shield. So let's see if we can. Any iron around here? A little bit iron over there. We'll grab that. That should give us enough for a shielding shard. And we'll get back in here for the moment. And we can get a little bit more iridium down here. Maybe sneak up a little bit like that. We'll just keep sending it to the ship. Because we don't have the space here. We've got the shielding shard now, but I'm not going to consume that unless I really have to. We're still very low on iron, and we still need to repair this, and we still need to find some zinc. I think zinc's going to be an issue here. Oh, that's great. Got platinum down there. Let's go and get that platinum. We've got the resources. We'll just use this pile of iridium as an operational base. Anything else around here? There's some thamium over there. That's good. We really, really need some iron. This is what I'm going to need. So in the way, I'm going to do a walk. So as you can see here, guys, this may appear to be an easy start, but it's not an easy start. Even though in theory, I should be able to call my ship, it's not as easy as it looks. Go away, Mr. Sentinel. A little bit of iron there. We'll pick that up. I know. Just going to get back into this little enclave here. So it's actually back against some rock, which is not mineable. Going to need to remember that. Yeah, go away, Sentinel. Go away. You don't want to talk to me. You don't want to see me. So how far away is the ship, actually? I can't see my ship. Where is my ship? My ship's that way. And I've lost the base, actually. Great. The base is that way. There's the base there. Got to remember, as I'm not walking towards my ship. In fact, I could be. How close is my ship? Am I actually going in the right direction? It says 9 minutes. We're 2 minutes away from the shelter. So we could be in a situation where I'm actually going to be walking towards the ship rather than actually calling it. And it's just, I still haven't found any zinc. There's some thamium over there. Let's go and get. Oops, I'm running around here too far out. I'd forgotten about that. Nearly a bad mistake there, guys. The grid on the screen is the product of the scan. And let's just let this build back up again, and then we'll go out. Right, let's get back out. Scanner still recharging. Let's see if we can go find some iron. I really, really need to stock up on the iron. Oh, we got some resources here. We got a knowledge stone. We might as well grab that. And see what we got here. Jettison pod. Power canister, that's going to be useful. Where's the iron? Going to be down to scrabbling for little bits of iron this way. Yeah, I know you're a nice little creature. The CH is cryzonite. We can't mine that without an advanced mining laser. I think we can go across here and see what we can find. A bit more platinum here. No iron. Ooh. Come on, I think there was iron in front. If I hit that, you see it says advanced mining laser. acquire Detrenium. We can't mind that. This is the new features that came out with the game. We will be mining it eventually. Grab some more carbon just to be able to recharge our laser. And I think what we can do is, if I can find the Heridium. Where is the Heridium? I think we can take a little bit off the top. Thank you. That's exactly what I didn't need. I say, if we can take a little bit off the top, get back in here. So, what have we stocked up on? Oh, well, we've got a fascination bead. That can go. Don't really need that. Got a little bit of iron. Got some thamium. Got a bit of carbon. The best thing to do with carbon is to have it in your mining laser. Life support's still good. We've got a shielding shard. We still don't have enough iron to build another shielding shard. Got a power cell. What we're going to do is kind of get out, go up here, and we're going to mine a little bit off the top. So we'll still be able to keep this as a shelter, but with the top missing. I don't want to come down too far. Though we do have the shielding shard if things get a bit desperate. We'll just take a bit more off the top. And say we got some more Heridium over there. Let's try out a scan, see what's around. Got thamium over there. Let's see if we can go get the thamium before our environmental drops too low. Again, we'll grab some carbon. We're going to go for it. Keep an eye out for the whippy plants. A bit more plutonium looks like stashed in that area there. So we'll grab the thamium. We'll be okay, guys. Yes, I know. Shouldn't have done that. I think I've already gathered these, haven't I? And let's get back towards our... And we'll take a bit more off the top from this side. That means we've got 250 Heridium. So we'll get back into this little enclave. And that can go to the ship. So we've got 335. Five. So we've got enough Heridium now. What we need is more iron. Which way? That's the key factor. Do we go for the ship or do we go for the base? I think we're going to investigate that way first and then take it from there. I think that's enough. Let's throw a scan out this way. We're going to go over this direction first and see if we get to that Heridium. Let's look at that platinum there, if I already collected it. Yes, I've already collected it. I think we'll head for that Heridium pile spike there. Yes, I know. Thermal protection's always falling on a cold planet. This is... So I think if we can get into the base of this Heridium, that will give us a chance to... Not... Ah, oh, bugger. It's not Heridium. Okay, guys, I'm going to push this way and see if we can find anything here. I'm gambling on that there's a cave over there. If there's not, we're in trouble. And we could be dying early. There's Heridium over there. There's a nice big Heridium spike there. So let's get up over there. See if we can get into this tunnel, into this area here. So we'll just cut an enclave into here. Yep. Ooh. Grab some more carbon. I have a bit of a carbon fixation. If you can't use your beam, you're going to have a problem. How are we doing? So we've got loads of carbon. Stop the mining laser up. I think what I can do is send some of the carbon, the 250, to the ship as a reserve. That can go. We got a bit more iridium. Still can't build another shielding shard because there's not enough iron around. Is that iron? Yes. We're just mine these tiny little bits of iron here. That might make a big difference. I really, really need a cave. But what we do need is zinc. And that's what I'm looking for. And there's none around here. Great. And where's the ship? Ship's in that direction. And we've actually moved further away from the ship than before, which is just great. Right, guys, I'm going to go up here and see if I can see a cave. If not, we're going to kind of work our way back towards the base. But really, I want a cave. Oh, there's a cave down here. So let's get into the cave so we can mine some iron. This will solve our carlite sheet problem. It will also give us enough to recharge the thrusters, or the pulse engine, not the thrusters, sorry. Thrusters will need plutonium, something else that seems to have been very, very, very short supply at the moment. So what we're going to do is stand here and mine iron. There's a path there. Maybe we can sneak across to here. Now, one of the hazards in caves is there's these bugs that run around, and they can kill you. So it's actually looks like there's another entrance through there. So I think what we will do is go through here and see if we, that will extend our range a little bit further out. Building out here. Yeah, there's another exit here. That might take us closer to some zinc or something. Let's see what we got. 192. Hopefully we will be able to build a couple of carite sheets. Let's get that built. And I think what I'm going to do is stay here and we're going to finish off the task. I've got to get a bit more focused, guys. So let's get the job done. And then we will go on the quest for zinc. Because we've got the iridium. We might as well grab a bit of antrium while we're at it. I'm aware of the length of time that this video is going on, guys, as well. But apologies for that, but obviously you can see being out in the middle of nowhere, I've got no save points, and there's by no far yet am I safe. We should have enough now. Oh, I didn't mean to do that, and I can't get it now. Great. That's a bit of a cock up there, guys. You stack that up. I was so busy thinking of that. We need 32 zinc. And we still need some iron for the thrusters. That can go back to the ship. Right, we're going to mine a bit more iron, mainly for survival purposes now. Because I've just messed up that shielding shard and wasted those resources. And we need about 100 iron so that we can make shielding shards. And then we're going to go looking for zinc. Get here, right, a scan, there's some plutonium and thamium there. Certainly going to go and grab this plutonium, because we're very, very short on plutonium. And I'm certainly going to go get the thamium. Oh, I've got to stop doing that. I'm consuming life support, although, to be honest, that's going to be okay. Yes, I know. We'll grab the thamium. Now we've got to find zinc. I think we'll work our way back towards the cave. We may have to do the walk, guys. If you don't know what the walk is, the walk is the walk to the ship. And I've lost that cave. Oh, there it is there. So there isn't much out this way. Oh, we're gonna have to... Don't use your jetpack unless it's absolutely necessary. There wasn't anything in that direction. So let's see if we can work our way towards the ship. Get a bit more iron, might as well. Caves are incredibly valuable in that respect. And let's just recharge our laser as well. Got the mining tool nicely recharged. Just keep popping at the iron. Yes, but we just nipping across to this enclave here. I don't think we can get... We could worm our way through there, but I'm not sure if there's any benefit in that. Now the question is, ship or base? So how are we doing? Yeah, we got a shielding shard there, we got 4 carite sheets, 171 iron, 56 platinum, which means we've got enough for 2 more shielding shards. Let this build up to maximum. We're 2 minutes away from the shelter. The question is shelter or ship. So there's the ship that way. I think we're going to go back towards the Heridium. It looks like there might be a little bit of plutonium over there. So I think hopefully that will be plutonium. If it's not, if it's a plant, I'm going to be slightly annoyed. We got to find zinc. Yep, there's plutonium there. There's more plutonium over there. So this is going to be worth the trip. Because we need at least 200 to finance our first takeoff. And there's some more over there. You may have to use a shielding shard on this. Whippy plant is there. Certainly not going to let him kill me. So it looks like we're going to have to use our first shielding shard now, guys. There we are. Of course, we're going to make another one straight away. That can go to the ship. We'll get you up here. Looks like there's some platinum here. That would be useful. That will keep our wandering alive. Oh, this is going to be very useful. Yes, I know. Thermal protection falling. There's our Heridium base. I think I'm going to try and make the ship, actually, guys. And gamble on the fact that the Heridium, or we're going to find some zinc. Now let's get in under here. Ooh. This gives us a free recharge. Yes, I know I need 32 more zinc. I haven't found any zinc at all on any scanner whatsoever at the moment. So let's just recap. So we've got everything except zinc. We've got 246 plutonium, which is enough to recharge the ship. We've got loads of platinum now. We're a bit low on iron. And life support, we've got 166 thamium. I think I'll wait for this to drop a bit lower, and then I'll use the power canister for that. So I'm just going to let this recharge again, guys. And we're going to try and go for the ship. It may seem a bit crazy, but I think it's going to make sense. I haven't found any zinc around the base, So working our way towards the ship is it's got risks, but I think it's going to be a risk worth taking. Because to call the ship, we're going to have to make a bypass ship, which we can do. We've got plenty of plutonium and iron. But without access to zinc, we're just wasting our time. We can spend forever just sat here. So I need to have a goal or objective. I think we can work our way this way, so we've got a bit of a target. Hello, creature. So I think we're going to kind of go this way, throw out a scan, see if we can find some zinc. This could be a bit of a death march. But we need a new area to kind of research and gather. How far are we away from the ship? 9 minutes. Well, we can do that with two shielding shards. Yes, I know. But we're just gonna come this way. Now, I do have the redeemable content because I pre-ordered this game, and you can all stop laughing now. But I'm not going to use it. I'm gonna do this as if someone had bought the game now, and obviously you wouldn't have access to the redeemable content. It doesn't give you that much of an advantage, to be honest. It just gives you a slightly more upgraded ship. Yes, I know. I need a cave. I need a cave. I need something. Some platinum here. I'm certainly going to grab that. It's going to be very, very useful. The sun's come up, but it's still cold. Got some plutonium here. And oh, crud. Didn't see that whip plant, lash plant. Okay, let's keep going this way. There might be a cave or something over here. As I say, this is very much a calculated risk, guys. I'm a chancer, but I'm not that much of a chancer, guys. So we'll just make another shielding shard, and we'll just keep going towards the ship. Throw out a scan. What we are really, really looking for is zinc. There's plutonium and thallium there, but of course, once you embark on the walk, guys, you've got to keep going in the direction of your ship. You've got to be very careful not to digress too far. Could really, really look for need a cave. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. This could be a big mistake. I think we can grab some carbon on the way through. I'm not sure what my carbon status is. Yes, I know. And I've been hit by another whippy plant. And doesn't look like there's any caves around here. Thamium there. The quicker I can get a grenade launcher, the better. If you've got a grenade launcher, you can actually just blast a hole into the side of these planets. Getting low on iron again, so we need to mine some iron, and otherwise we won't be able to recharge our cold planets. I hate cold planets. I'd rather do a toxic planet or a irradiated planet. You see here, there's virtually no iron on the surface at all. So we really, really need a cave. Is there a cave that way? There's nothing in the way of a cave on the surface. Oh, there's some iron there. We'll grab that iron. Normally, spikes like this can indicate that there's a cave, but I think if we can mine off some of this stuff. And of course, I'm wasting my protection by actually standing here mining the iron, which is the catch-22 situation. No cave around here, so we've got to keep going. There's some more platinum here. That's going to be useful. Come on, give me a cave, guys. Give me a cave. Come on. Sorry, this is getting tense, guys. This is getting very, very intense. You've got no protection around here at all. No caves. Got some more platinum. We'll find loads of platinum. So, let's find another Shining Shard. Grab that. And put us after. Yes, I know. We need iron, iron, iron. Keep going, guys. Keep going. Grab as we walk across this mine, iron field. Keep walking towards the ship. Some plutonium down there. Throw out a scan. We've got to find some zinc. Zinc, 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 please. Plutonium down there. That could be useful. A bit of zinc plutonium there. Put some thamium over there. We'll grab that. And we're still working our way towards the ship. Hello, creatures. I'd love to say hello, but sorry, I've got something far more important on my mind. Is there a cave over here? Are you misleading me, game? Are you leading me to my death? Yes, great. Yes, I know. Get that in there. Right, let's keep going towards the ship. Oh, I thought that was zinc briefly, but it's not. How far away is the ship now? Still 5 minutes away. Still way too far. Enough. Get out of the way, creature. I shouldn't have done this, guys. Falling. I'm in trouble here, guys. This was a bit of a bad mistake. So it goes to show, even the easiest starts, or what appears to be on the surface an easy start, may not necessarily be such an easy start. I think there's a cave over there. Let's try another scan. We've got to try and find some zinc. Thamium over there. That's a resource there. Charge that, and we need more iron. We've got to find iron. We've got to find iron again. We're just going to keep going, guys. We're going to have to keep going. I think we're going to have to resort to the run of death. How far are we away from the ship? Yes, I know. We're too far away. I really, really need a cave now. And there is no caves. I think we're going to have to stop and mine iron. Come on. Come on, grab the iron. That's titanium. That's plutonium. Can we make another Shielding shard. Nope. Find iron, 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 iron. Pop. God. Back online. Ha! Done it. And we're gonna just stand here and quite literally mine iron, guys. I know it's boring, but and we're running out of. Recharge our mining laser. Yes, I know. Right, let's get moving. Grab as much iron as we can as we go through. While we look for a cave or something. This is going to be very much keep on the move, keep moving, keep moving. I think we're gonna just try and. There's a cave over there, but can I get to it? Oh, is it a cave? Is it a cave? There's some more iron here. Okay. But we still need more iron. Normally iron is just everywhere. This is becoming a distraction. I could be walking past zinc at the moment. Is what I'm looking for. I still can't find any zinc. Come on. Just run for it. Ah, it's a nice big wadge of iron here at last. Something worth actually worth mining. Still only 14. Still can't find any iron on this planet. How can you have a planet that doesn't have much iron? There's a cave there. Right, guys. We've found a cave. Let's get to it. Out of the way, creatures. Bit of thamium there. We're going to make it, guys. We're going to make it, even if I do stop for the thamium. Come on, up the side here, and we'll stock up with iron, and we'll be okay then, guys. Up the side of the mountain. I don't really want to use the shielding shard unless I have to. Let's get in under that lean-to. Yes, we've made it. No, don't do this to me. Don't do this to me, game. Ooh. Right, now we can seriously stock up on iron. There are times when I can really hate this game. As I say, this should have been an incredibly easy start. There should have been a nice wadge of zinc right next to the base, which I probably was, and I've missed it. But this is the choices you make with this game. But I'm certainly going to stand here now and we're going to go right up and stock up completely on iron while our thermal shields are building up. Right, we're up top. We're going to grab some carbon, work our way towards the ship as quickly as possible. And as I say, we're going to work our way towards the ship. Bit of plutonium there. Throw out a scan, see if we can find any zinc. And some zinc. Certainly going to go for that. That's exactly what I'm looking for. Looks like I must have walked straight past it when, because I hadn't thrown a scan out. So we've got zinc. As I say, we keep walking towards the ship. Pick up some carbon when we get to those trees. And we should be able to, if we can get to the ship, I will drop a save game, and that's where I'm going to end this part, guys, before I have a complete and utter nervous breakdown. So we'll keep moving towards the ship. Grab the carbon on the way through. Yes, I know the thermal protection's falling, but we'll be okay. Let's keep moving towards the ship all the time. There's some thamium there. Two nice bits of thamium, can't pass that up, because that will help us recharge our shields. Bit of iron there, but I think we'll be okay to make a shielding shard, because I don't want to waste that slot. The last thing I want is to be caught out with that. I'll keep, how far are we all? Yes, I know. Just charge that. I'm certainly not going to use the zinc by accident. So how far are we from the ship now? 54 seconds. And we got some iron here. Yeah, well, I'll let that milestone go through. Well, can't. The ship must be very, very close now. There it is. There's the good old flying brick. Ah, oh, crud. And it looks like we've got a local supply of iron. That's good. Bit of plutonium. And we've got to the ship, guys. And that is where I'm going to stop. And I'm just going to drop out to drop a save just out of habit. Because this is where we're going to pick up in the next part, guys. I think I've had enough of this. We've walked all across the map. We had a good start and there wasn't any zinc, which is the nature of the game. We still got to find some zinc, so that means I've still got a lot of wandering around to do, and it's taken me a very long part just to get to this far. And so this is where I'm gonna leave it, guys. Hope you've enjoyed this first part. I am quite literally shaking because I thought I'd blown it completely by setting out for the ship, but maybe it's a good decision. And so this is where I'm going to leave it, guys. Hope you enjoyed the episode. Hope you found it interesting. And until next time, whatever you do, enjoy your gaming.